to tell one thing. For doing this velocity diagrams, you have to take this roller scale. It is easy to do the diagrams, okay, without a drafter and without other instruments. Hello friends, today we will discuss how to draw the velocity diagrams for a given mechanism. So here the given question is, the crank of a slider crank mechanism rotates clockwise at a constant speed of 300 rpm. Here the crank is rotating clockwise with 300 rpm speed. Okay, what is the mechanism, given mechanism? Slider crank mechanism. This will indicate it has one crank and one slider will be there. Okay, so after that, the given data is the crank is 150 mm. Okay, the length of the crank is 15 cm and the connecting rod is 600 mm long. The connecting rod length is 60 cm long. Okay, let us do the rough diagram here. So in the rough diagram, first take the crank length is 15 cm. Okay, so always take crank is moving about the fixed point. Let us take it is a O point. O is a fixed point. Now I am taking this is B, end point. OB is the crank. How much length it is? 15 cm. 15 cm. And then connecting rod is 60 cm. Now here one connecting rod. Okay, it is connected to the slider. Okay, so I am taking A. This slider is moving inside this guides like this. Okay, horizontally. Here A is the slider. AB is the connecting rod. And these are the guides, fixed one, and this point is also fixed one. If you are taking here, the axis passing through this slider and this center is same. Okay, so we can do the line here. So here, this is the connecting rod. It is given 60 cm. And how many links this mechanism has? So whatever fixed points are there, this one and this guide vanes are the first link, and OB is the second link. Crank it is. And AB is the connecting rod, it is the third link, and this slider, okay, it is a fourth link. Okay, it has four links. So whenever this is moving clockwise, it is given here the crank is rotating clockwise at a speed of 300 rpm. So this crank is rotating clockwise. Clockwise is coming in this direction, so it is 300 rpm revolution per minute. Okay, this is the given data. Here I will write so this is the slider crank mechanism. In this mechanism, whenever this crank is rotating, okay, this connecting rod will move or reciprocate like this. Okay, it is reciprocating like this. Whenever it is going this direction, this connecting rod will move in upward direction. This slider will come in this horizontal direction. Okay, so continuous rotation of the crank will make this connecting rod reciprocate upward and downward, and then this slider will move this direction and this direction. Rotary motion is converted into sliding motion or reciprocating motion of the slider. Okay, this is the mechanism of the crank mechanism. Rotary motion is converted into reciprocating motion. Okay, so the path of this crank is, if you are doing, it is a circular path like this. So here, whenever this crank is coming, okay, this point on the horizontal line, it is outer dead center position, ODC. Whenever it is coming here, this side, it is IDC, inner dead center position. Okay, so crank is rotating clockwise in the circular path. This mechanism, what we have to find? First question, find linear velocity of a point which is 200 mm from the slider of the connecting rod. What they have taken here on the connecting rod, they have taken one point. Okay, so we need to find velocity direction of this point, okay, on the connecting rod. So where that point on the connecting rod, as we know connecting rod is AB, we have to take one point on this rod. We need to find the velocity and that point. Where that point means, it is 200 mm from the slider. So from the slider, A is the slider, from A it is 200 mm. Okay, now I am taking this point is some D point. Okay, this gap is 200 or 20 cm we can take. We need to find velocity of this point VD, the D point. That is the first question. And then next question is, we need to find angular velocity, that is omega, okay, duration of the connecting rod. Which is the connecting rod? AB is the connecting rod. So in the second question, we have to find angular velocity, that is omega, connecting rod means AB. So this is the angle 45 degrees from the inner dead center position. They have given, we have to find all these values at a crank angle of 45 degrees from the inner dead center position, from IDC. From IDC, this crank is making 45 degrees. So this angle is, we can take 45 degrees. Okay, so this is a given slider crank mechanism. So here we have to do the space diagram. Let us take space diagram. Here why we are doing this diagram is, whatever lengthy dimensions are there, we can't do on the paper. Okay, 60 centimeter line we can't do in the small paper. So what we are doing in space diagram is, we are taking one scale. Okay, so in that scale we are reducing the dimension, we are doing the same diagram as it is according to that scale. Let us take one scale here. The scale, initially I am taking one, any length, I am reducing this length. I am considering this 15 centimeter is equal to 3 centimeter. Okay, so I am taking 15 centimeter is equal to some 3 centimeter. Okay, write down here it is a scale, we are assuming like that. Okay, and here OB is crank length. OB is, instead of 15 centimeter it is 3 centimeter. And which is the next bigger value, connecting rod length, it is 60 centimeter. Okay, so here 60 centimeter, how much length we have to consider? For it is a less value, it is a more value. For less value it is also less, for more value it is also more. So that we can take more by less into this 3. Okay, so we are getting, in it more value is 60, 60 by 15 into 3. Okay, how much it is? So 12 centimeter. So instead of 60, we can take 12 centimeter. So AB length is 12 centimeter. Now I will write here, AB connecting rod length is 12 centimeter. And the crank is 3 centimeter. And the connecting rod is 12 centimeter. And which is the dimension, next dimension? This AD is 200 mm or 20 centimeter. We will convert here. Okay. So for 20 centimeter, how much length? So take the same one for in these two. Okay, 15 is the less value, this is a bigger value. For less value it is also less, for more value it is also more. So we can take more by less into 3. We are comparing this one and this one, substitute the value, more in these two is 20 by less is 15 into 3, it is 4 centimeter. So instead of 20 AD length, we have to take 4 centimeter. Now AD is equal to 4 centimeter. Now keep in the box. Now what we did, we have reduced all the dimensions, okay, in this taken scale. Now we do the space diagram by taking the new dimensions. Okay, let us do first one horizontal line. On it mark the any point, that is O point. Doing this line, take any point, that is O point, and then take 45 degrees line. So mark the 45. Now join these two. In this line, what is the OB length? OB is 3 centimeter. Take 3 centimeter in this direction. From 6 to 3, I will take 3 centimeter. Okay, which is this point? It is a B point. Mark here. After marking B, next is AB length, connecting rod. What is the AB length? 12 centimeter. So by using compass and scale, I am taking 12 centimeters. Okay. Now B as center, I am doing an arc on the horizontal line. Now this intersection point is A point. Okay, it is a slider. Join A and B, it is a connecting rod. Okay, and then after that, mark the D point, it is 20 centimeter. 20 means here it is a 4 centimeter. It is a 4 from A. This point is D point. Okay, and this is the space diagram. This angle is 45 degrees. This is the crank, this is the connecting rod. We are taking one point D, at which we have to find the velocity. Okay, let us do the velocity diagram for finding the velocity. Before doing the velocity diagram, I want to tell one thing. Whatever links we are taking, those links' velocities are always perpendicular to the link position. Okay, OB link velocity is perpendicular to this position of the OB, and AB velocity is perpendicular to this AB. Okay, so just I am marking the velocity directions of these two links. Okay, so take any point on it at which we can mark the velocity direction. By using it, just do the perpendicular line. So join this point to this one. In this direction, velocity will come. Okay. Just for marking the direction, we can take any point. Just give the direction for the velocity of this link. For this AB link, velocity is perpendicular to this link. Take any point on it. Just do perpendicular line. So join this one and this one. In that direction, we can take the velocity. Velocity symbol. AB, okay, we can take like this direction of velocity of connecting rod, and this is velocity of OB, or we can write here velocity of OB link, but O is the fixed point. For fixed point, velocity is 0, that's why we can write VB also. Here we did the direction of velocities. Doing the velocity diagrams, here first mark the fixed point. As we know, O is the fixed point, so a fixed point means it has no moment, so because of it, velocity is 0. So just initially mark fixed point here. And then A, mark the A path. A is slider. It is moving only in the horizontal direction. So just do one line like this. Here we do the velocity diagram, this side. Marked in the velocity diagram O point and slider velocity direction I did here. Okay, horizontal line. And in the velocity diagram, here one data is given. This crank is rotating 300 RPM. Okay, clockwise. So N value is given. N OB is given. So here we can take that value. OB or NB also we can take. It is 300 RPM clockwise. It is given. From it we can find the angular velocity. The value here, the symbol is omega. The formula is 2 pi NB by 60. 2 pi N by 60. Okay. Substitute this value here. It is 2 pi. NB means 300 by 60. So do this value with calci. Got omega B is angular velocity 31.41. radians per second. Written VB. Okay, with the VB is linear velocity. We can mark linear velocities in this velocity diagram. So formula is omega B into this length of the link. What is OB? Okay, length of the OB. Given length. How much OB length is? OB length is equal to 15 centimeter. The B is equal to 31.41 into 15 centimeter means take in terms of meters, 15 by 100. So do with calci this value. We got velocity of B, or crank velocity is 4.712 meter per second. Okay, meter by second means it is a velocity unit. We have to mark this on the velocity diagram. Here we are taking in centimeters. Okay, for marking the length. That's why I am taking one scale. 4.712 meter per second I am taking, it is some 3 centimeter. Okay, so this 3 centimeter or crank speed is in which direction? Already we have marked the direction of crank. Okay, in the direction from O point, this is a O point, we have to do the line. Okay, 3 centimeter line in that direction. I'm using the roller scale for doing the velocity diagram. Here keep the scale coincide with this velocity line, and tilt this up to O. From O take the crank velocity. As I told, it is 3 centimeter. 1, 2 and 3. 3 centimeter. Okay, just do one line here. As I told, in this velocity diagram we are marking the small letters. Okay, this will indicate VB. Okay, the end point is B point, small letter, and then we can take the arrow in this direction. Now after marking B, here we don't know the connecting rod velocity, but we know the direction. The direction of connecting rod velocity is in this direction. Now keep the scale coincide with this line. Okay, and then because we know B point here, okay, now tilt the scale slowly up to B. Okay, here do the line up to this horizontal line. Okay, and what is the intersection point of this B and O? This B and O is A. Okay, it is a small a. Now this is the velocity diagram. If you are taking OA, OA direction is in this direction. And here if you are taking AB, AB direction is in this direction. This will give the velocity of A, slider velocity. And this is the connecting rod velocity, VAB or VBA. And this is the crank velocity, VB. Okay. And then mark the here small letters and we can give the capital letters. And this side also UVB, okay, capital letter. So this is the method of doing the velocity diagram. Now in it what we have to find? Velocity of D point. Now we have to mark D point in this velocity diagram. Where is D? It is on AB. Okay, on AB we have to mark the D point. So how to mark D point? By using the comparison method, we will compare this velocity line and the given space diagram line. Okay, just a comparison, we can find the position of D. By AD by AB is equal to, in it, D let us assume at some place, small AD by small AB. Okay, so here substitute these values. Here first find out how much AB length. By using the scale, we can find it easily. It is 2.2 centimeter. Okay, so this value vector is 2.2 centimeter. Now what is the ED length? ED is given, actually it's 20 centimeter or 200 mm. Substitute here 200 by what is AB length? 100 mm or 60 centimeter. Take same units here, whatever units here, here also take same units, is equal to AD. We had to find what is AB length? 2.2. So find out AD in it, position of D. So 200 by 600 into 2.2. This value is 0.733 centimeters. Okay. So here on AB line, we have to mark AD length. This length, it is 0.733. So 0.7 we can mark here. Okay, this is the D point. This point. OD vector will give the velocity of D point on the AB link. Now join O and D. Okay, and give the direction. Always remember, all these directions are from the fixed point. Okay, this vector, OD vector, is will give the velocity of D point. Okay, and we can write V capital D also. Measure this length. 2.6 centimeters. This vector OD is 2.6 centimeters. But we want velocity. Okay. This velocity we are taking one scale here. Okay. For 3 centimeter, we are considering it is 4.712 meter per second. For 2.6 centimeters, how much velocity? Okay. And then for more value it is also more, for less it is also less. So here we can take less by more into this value. So substitute these values. Less value means 2.6 by more means 3 into 4.712. It will give the velocity of D point. After finding this, so here one question is, can you find AB velocity, connecting rod velocity? AB velocity is VAB. Where VAB? This is a VAB. Okay. By using this length, okay, already we have measured it is 2.2 centimeter. By using this value, we can find the velocity of AB. So it is, here we are taking one scale. For 3 centimeter, it is 4.712 meter per second. Okay. For this value, AB length is 2.2. Just now we have measured. For 2.2 centimeters, how much velocity? Just now I told, for more value it is also more, for less we can take less by more into this value. Substitute these values, 2.2 by 3 into 4.712. This value we are getting 3.45 meter per second. So this is value of velocity of connecting rod, VAB. Okay, so here I will write VAB is equal to 3.45 meter per second. I should keep in the box. Now here we already did this VB value here. and VAB just now we did here, okay, and then we did here D velocity, D point velocity. We can find the slider velocity also by measuring VA value, okay. We can find the velocity of A also. Okay. Let us see the next question given. So here we have to find angular velocity of AB, that is the connecting rod. Okay. We know the connecting rod linear velocity. We have to find angular velocity. So angular velocity, linear velocity, one formula is here. Okay. Linear velocity of AB is equal to angular velocity of AB into AB length. Okay, length of AB, link. From it we can substitute this VAB value. We have to find this value and we have to take AB length. AB length is 60 cm. Okay, so substitute these values. VAB is 3.45. Just to one line here. Is equal to omega AB into what is the length of AB it is given. It is 600 mm or 60 cm. Take in terms of meters. Okay, so 60 by 100. Because we are taking velocities or meter per second. Okay, so find out omega AB 3.45. Into 100 by 60. Okay. Do we can see this value? So this value is 5.75 for angular velocity, units are radians per second. Okay. So this value we will get in the for this question, omega AB. Okay. The omega AB value. So we did this value. VD value and omega AB value. Okay. After doing this velocity diagram, directions of the links are important. If you see these three links here, okay, these links I'm keeping the arrows in this direction. So all arrows are starting from the fixed point. Okay, mark like this. And here, if you see at the B point, one arrow is coming in the upper direction, one arrow is going in the downward direction. So at the B point, let's take the B point in the mechanism. Okay. So this B point is crank end and then connecting rod one end. Okay, here this crank is trying to rotate in the clockwise direction. Okay, it is trying to move in this direction and this is trying to come in this direction. Okay, so here if you are taking the B point like this, okay, it is trying to move in this direction, it is going upward. So arrow is coming here and then this downward direction. So same thing I am keeping here. Okay, and for the remaining links from the fixed point, arrows are coming. So this is the method of marking the arrows. I want to tell one thing, for doing this velocity diagrams, as you have to take this roller scale, it is easy to do the diagrams, okay, without a drafter and without other instruments. So in this process, initially take the question and do the rough diagram. After that, reduce the dimensions by taking the scale, do the space diagram by taking the reduced scale, and then do the velocity diagrams. So in velocity diagrams, directions are important. From mark the arrows for the velocity diagram and find out the required values.